Stop searching and start finding. Part 6, Boolean operators. Keep in mind that when you search both in the databases or a basic search engine, that you're searching across hundreds of thousands of potential sources. If you search for just one keyword or idea, you are likely to get way more results than you actually need, which makes it even harder to identify ones that will be helpful. Depending on your topic, you'll probably use anywhere from 2 to 5 keywords or search terms. This is where Boolean operators come in. They can help you narrow or broaden your search by connecting those keywords to create a search string that the database can understand. Say you're interested in learning more about anxiety in college students. Instead of searching each individual term, anxiety, college, and student, and then sifting through 3 sets of results looking for potential sources, you can use a Boolean operator that connects ideas and tells the database to search for them at the same time. To connect different ideas, concepts, or keywords into one search string, use AND. This tells the database that all search terms must be present in every result. Using AND between search terms will narrow the search. For example, when we search the database using anxiety, and college, and student as the search string, the database looks for articles that include all keywords. It's important to note that both databases and web search engines assume that there is an AND between each search term, unless you specify otherwise with a different Boolean operator, like or not. To search for the same idea or concept using different keywords or synonyms, use OR. This tells the database that any of the search terms can't be present in the results. Using OR between your search terms will broaden the search. When we search the database using college or university as our search string, the database looks for articles that include either of those keywords. To eliminate results that include a specific keyword, use NOT. This tells the database to ignore a specific concept that may be implied by your search terms. Using NOT will narrow your search. If we're searching the databases for resources on anxiety, but do not want any articles that reference phobia, you can use the search string anxiety not phobia, eliminating all the results that reference phobia. Be sure to use NOT at the end of the search string to keep from confusing the database. Anything after NOT, the database will think you don't want to include. There are many words that have the same root word, like sun, sunshine, sunny, and sunlight. It can be time-consuming to construct a search using OR. Instead, if the root word is the same, you can use truncation. This will allow you to search for all variations of that word without having to type out each one. For databases, the truncation wildcard is the asterisk symbol. Placing the asterisk at the end of a root word, like sun, tells the database that you're okay with any variation of that word appearing in the results. Be careful how much you shorten a word with truncation. It can broaden your search too much and bring back results that are not relevant. When you need to search for more than one concept, but want to use synonyms to make sure you cover all your bases, you can use parentheses to group similar ideas and concepts. This tells the database that the words in the parentheses should be treated as one concept or idea. So instead of having to type out each search separately, you can combine it into one search string. If you get stuck during your search, don't hesitate to reach out. Visit us at libraries.wright.edu/ask. This video is licensed under an attribution, non-commercial, share-alike, Creative Commons license.